Thank you so much. A very good afternoon to the stalwarts, pioneers, the team, and the audience for this e-conference, the fifth e-conference. This is my first forensic conference, as I am from the Department of Prosthodontics and Implantology, Hitkani Dental College and Hospital Assistant Professor. So I would like to present before you all the cross-sectional institutional-based study and the survey conducted amongst third years, final years, and the interns. The survey was regarding the awareness regarding the knowledge of dental records in forensic dentistry among undergraduate dental students of Madhya Pradesh, India, the central part of India. The aim of the study was to assess the knowledge, of course, and the objectives were to determine the student's opinion regarding the current dental curriculum. So the questionnaire was prepared and it was divided into the four parts, customized based on the previously published articles. The data received was categorized as the nominal data, and the answers received were tabulated and statistically analyzed. The results which were obtained were divided into the four sets. The first set was the knowledge regarding the importance of dental records. So the audience, the sample size which was taken was 500. It was divided amongst interns, final years and third years. And they were asked about the various questions that are they aware of the dental records importance. So 79% agreed with it, but 45% didn't attended any sessions or the classes related to the same. And if given the chance, 95% agreed, yes, they will proceed for this. They also agreed regarding the importance of medico-legal records maintenance. In India, they are also aware regarding the current scenario of India that it is legally bound to maintain the records in India, whether they are practiced or not. And according to them, the fastest, cost-effective and scientific method was dental record comparison as compared to the fingerprinting or DNA comparison. Next slide, please. Next slide, please.
Ma'am, we are on the second option, that is awareness of students regarding maintenance of dental records. So you want me to shift again?
No. Yes, thank you. So the second part was the awareness of students regarding the maintenance of dental records and their duration and preferred method, basically. So they were asked about the sufficient awareness about how to maintain dental records. Yes, we should maintain, but how to maintain dental records? So 70% agreed that to it. And if there are particular guidelines that they should be aware of defining the duration of storage, maximum were disagreed with it. No, the previous slide, please. Yes. And the preferred method of maintaining and storing dental records should be electronic compared to manual, or both. Next slide, please. Which method should be followed for faster accessibility, manually maintained or electronic dental records? So electronic was chosen. Smiling photographs should be included. So they agreed. Maximum people were agreed. And for the storing of the digital radiographs, they agreed with it again. The third section was the knowledge of students regarding contents of dental records, including personal details and diagnostic aids. The personal details should include full name, date of birth and age, gender, contact details, complete address and occupation as compared to the individual detail. Yes, it is necessary to record diagnostic aids and their reports in the patient's file and diagnostic aid reports will be useful as an antemortem record, they agreed as well. The last section was the most perceived barrier to good dental record keeping, students' perception on attending CDE programs and workshops. So the most preferred barrier which they have chosen was lack of training program or CDE as compared to the lack of time, lack of experience, and increased workload. They have not attended, maximum have not attended the CDE programs or workshops, but they agreed with that there is a need to know the forensic dentistry. Yes, they were aware regarding the cases where dental identification was used for identification or medical legal purpose with the different medias. Next slide, please. So to conclude my study, the current study clearly shows that there is inadequate knowledge and poor attitude among dental students in the state of Madhya Pradesh, and it reflects the current scenario of our country in the field of forensic dentistry. This condition, however, could be improved if necessary steps are to be taken to make forensic odontology as a part of our curriculum. In addition, periodic conferences and seminars, if conducted, would help the dental students enrich their knowledge of forensic odontology. And the practical application of the practical aspects of my study is to provide an app to all the dental students in the internship, so that before completion of internship, they can go through that app and they can perform the course along with the examination, the self-evaluation and the evaluation through various committees before giving them the completion in their term. These are my references. Thank you so much.